Good morning, Derbyverse, and welcome to the 2019 Women's Flat Track Derby Association Continental Cup here in Orem, Utah, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Happy Valley Derby Darlins. Coming up, we have a game against the Happy Valley Derby Darlins, Molly Morbids, and the Beattown Derby Dames. Can you take us through the rosters there? I'm Bobby Narco. I'm joined by Speaker of the House.
Hi, we're people.
Our producer is Chloroform Cupcake today. Can you take us through that Beattown roster?
Well, yeah, so coming in here. For this team, we have number 10, Mia. Jumbo. Number 18, Kaylor Swift. Number 19, Risque. 1976, Strawberry Champagne. 21, Patton Boppin. 240, Burgie Knights. 314, Activist. 316, Riveter Rosie. 36, Busty Chops. Number 5, Rita Villain. Number 7, Lucky Eddie. Number 8, Bad Juju. 805, Zelda Hits Gerald. 820, Just Abby. 821, Low Red Kaboom. 911, Pyro Princess. 9975, Gymnasty. That's our team. California.
Yeah, from Visalia, California, USA, the Beattown Derby Dames. They are seeded number 12th. They are ranked number 78 by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, and they come to this tournament with a record of 2-5. Coaches for V-Town, we have Coach, we have Molly the Harchet, and we have Hallelujah. And then did you want to take us through Happy Valley as well there, Speaker?
Well, with Happy Valley, we have O-Negative, 131 Kicking Assets, 2063 Enterprise. I love that one. 2113, Pearl of Scars, 223, Valkyrie Vixen, 26, Maid Carrion, 418, Mooner, 428, Olivia Wildchild, 503, Hip Knocket Therapy, 521, Gypsy Wiperout, 700, Triple X, number 8, Sookie Slaphouse, 801, Orange Crusher, 831, Biz Hummingbird, and 84, Wham Bam Julianne.
All right. And the Happy Valley Derby Darlins, they are the Molly Morbids. They are out of Salem, Utah, USA. They are seeded number 5 in this tournament, ranked number 46 by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, and they come to this tournament with a record of 7-5. Coaches for Happy Valley, we have Ask Couch, Honeymooner, Cookie, Klaus, and Half the Ruler.
Yeah, I'm real interested in this matchup. One, I mean, you've got the host team coming in, so, I mean, you know, they've been having to work a lot to get this all going, get this all started. The question is, you know, it's like you see with a lot of leagues, a lot of your primary players are also a lot of your upfront kind of people, you know, getting out there, doing the things, making things happen as a league. So start to wonder if some of that double duty might kind of get them a little bit here. But I think, you know, probably a little bit of adrenaline being, you know, you're the host, it's the first game coming in here. We'll probably carry him over at least through the first half.
Yeah, being the host and also being the higher seed, I think that's going to get some credit to the Happy Valley team here. Though we got to tip your cap to Visalia making the cut for the Continental Cups.
Yeah, and so we've seen a lot of these teams that are playing in this cup, they've kind of played each other, or if not each other, they've played, you know, like opponents, you know, so they have a common opponent between them. And this has been a lot of parity in the outcomes of these games between these teams. So, you know, I know we're looking at, you know, a fairly substantial differentiation in our seedings coming in here. But, you know, whatever we have on paper, they're going to tell us the story on the track.
True that, Speaker of the House. Truer words were never spoken. Happy Valley is going to be skating in gray with pink and black accents. V-Town's going to be skating in white and black with red accents. So we're going to refer to them occasionally as gray and white. Happy Valley, the team in gray on the left side of your scoreboard, and V-Town, the team in white on the right side of your scoreboard. Out on the jammer line right now, in white, number 11 is Talia, and in gray, number 503 is Hip Knocket Therapy. And here we go. We are underway.
It's already seen multi-point contact there from V-Town trying to run a little bit of a split pack. And, yeah.
First penalty of the game is a multiplayer block, and lead gets picked up by Happy Valley. Jammer in the lead, not being the lead jammer. That means the jam's going to get called off. So, nothing. Our first scoreless jam here in jam number one.
Yeah, I think it was one of those moments where it looked like they were trying to run a little bit of an attempt of offense, but it ended up creating, you know, when their jammer pushed so far forward, it divided the packs up enough to where now that that offensive player ended up having to kind of bridge it all out. So kind of lost that out there a little bit.
All right, now on the jammer line right now, it looks like we have number 8 in gray. That's Suki Slaphouse. And number 240 is Burgie Knights. Bergie Knight's out. Suki out for a lead. That's two leads in a row for Happy Valley.
Yeah, Suki Stophouse, familiar face. A bit of a transfer in here. Not too far of a go to get to this Happy Valley team. Go ahead and break that pack. Call the first four. Going to put us some points onto the board.
Yeah, both teams putting points on the board. Four for the gray team and three for the white team, setting their respective high scores. And our first lead change happening here in jam number two. Gray team did lose their pivot. Happy Valley lost their pivot, so they'll be down one, actually down two, heading into the next set of whistles, and V-Town at full strength.
Yeah, going to see how this pack advantage, of course, obviously going to be something for Happy Valley to contend with here. The pack disadvantage, I should say. V-Town have an opportunity to go ahead and get that lead, and they do.
Yeah, jammers are Valkyrie Vixen picking up lead, and Kaylor Swift picking up lead.
Now, the question is, are they going to be able to take advantage of the pack advantage here? Of course, one coming back into place, and now Happy Valley able to combine it up a little bit. Yeah, V-Town doesn't look afraid to go in there and mix it up with some offense, already putting some quick hits in there to open up bodies. I like the active offense.
And our second lead change of the game comes in jam number three. V-Town taking now the lead, 7-4, holding Happy Valley scoreless on that last set of whistles.
And I want to definitely thank one of our sponsors, Rydell. Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in roller skates for over 70 years. That's Rydell Skates at Rydell.com.
Out on the jamming line, number 831 is Busy Hummingbird, and number 316 is Riveter Rosie.
Yeah, I'm watching V-Town. They're kind of playing a bit of a flat three with a brace that flows between the point of contact. Not able to ride that out this time as once again Happy Valley able to grab that lead status.
Yeah, three out of four jams, Happy Valley's had lead.
Happy Valley spit off a little bit of a 2-2, now kind of reformed that up a little bit. Interesting to see that little, I guess it was trying to make sure they cover space there in that apex.
Jam with the cover off. Trying to pass it to number 1308. That would be Rambo. The Rambo forced away. Track cut coming in. V-Town losing a blocker on the track cut. That's number 7, Lucky Eddie, on the track cut.
Yeah, both teams now having sent two to the box each, so we're back out here in play. The advantage, of course, now for Happy Valley. Happy Valley taking full use of it now, able to drop that blocker back, looking to try and get the offense. I'm happy to see this so far, Bobby. Both teams willing to get in there and throw one out there to kind of open up space.
Keeping those bridges intact so that everybody can keep blocking. Initial pass completed on the star stash, so the jam gets called, and we have another lead change. In four jams, we've had three lead changes.
So, yeah, you know, the quick lead gotten there by Happy Valley, but definitely showing that just because you get lead on us, we're not going to break down on our defense once you come back around, was V-Town. Kind of saw a little bit of that in the big O from them as well. You know, they were giving up the quick leads to some of the teams they were playing, but they were really hunkering down for that scoring pass defense.
Mooner out on the line right now for Happy Valley. Happy Valley has yet to repeat a jammer, and that's Talia back out on the line. First repeat jammer for either team.
Yeah, once again, both teams are staying really contained in their defense. You see a lot of teams now playing with a single point of contact and flexing off of that. They're definitely trying to play their controlled space and keep a body in contact at all times.
Second lead of the game for V-Town.
Yeah, once again, Happy Valley trying to get in there and run the offense. Swimming around it was V-Town.
Yeah, nice job forcing that blocker to the infield. Didn't catch the number, but a great block by that blocker who's facing us.
Good job by V-Town, not getting lost in the mix, trying to run the offense. Sometimes you end up losing that jammer. Good job that time by number 36. That's Busty Chops, able to seal down the inside on the back cut.
Nice hit at the back of the pack by number 9975, Jim Nasty, forcing that Happy Valley jammer to the infield.
Yeah, once again, Happy Valley up front now. Multi-point contact, two shoulders in on the jammer. No track to move, lateral.
In front of the pack gets taken back now. All the skaters in between the pivot line and the jammer line. almost.
Yeah, it seems like both jammers kind of been worn down a little bit, so not really trying to move those laterals real fast, so they're kind of gliding into that contact.
V-Town loses a blocker on direction of play.
Yeah, once again, this time, Taffy Valley playing the bend, don't break kind of defense, as we're going to lose Happy Valley's pivot off for a track cut now. Taking away that option of a potential star pass. Not that we'd seen any attempts of it thus far, even though Jammer's been locked in tight by that V-Town defense.
Pack got split a little bit. They had to reform, did it very quickly. Three more points on the board, and we have another lead change.
Also, don't forget, we want to shout out to Rideout, Radar Wheels, Powerdyne, and RollerCon. Well, RollerCon just happened. I wonder if people are still probably recovering
from
that.
There'll be another one next year.
Yeah, a lot of active defenses thus far. I mean, they're not kind of trying to take any of the bait to go to the edges. They're staying home and always keeping at least a body in contact. Quick move to the inside, though.
Yeah, Suki Slaphouse picking up lead jam on the jam line for V-Town. It's number 240, Bergie Knights.
Yeah, Suki, very dynamic jammer out there. I've seen in a different uniform, a little white and blue uniform.
She's
playing for Happy Valley now, though.
She's two for two on the jammer line. 1 point picked up by the team in gray. No points picked up by V-Town. This makes it a 1 point game. 9 for Happy Valley, 10 for V-Town.
So, yeah, you know, we're seeing this close game, but for in the early part, V-Town was kind of leaking off some of their blockers off to the penalty box, and now it's been Happy Valley. And neither team seems to be able to really take advantage of the lack of skaters out there other than just maybe getting a quick lead. It's not turning into points.
Yeah, we haven't had that single jam where there's been multiple scoring passes. Jammers right now are Hip Knocket Therapy and Kaylor Swift, and picking up lead jam is Kaylor Swift.
Yeah, and a forearm's going to lose another Happy Valley blocker off the penalty box. It's going to be kicking assets. Yeah, Bobby, once again, I mean, these are just some really quick jams. I mean, we had that one that kind of dragged on a bit because just nobody was breaking out, but there wasn't a lot of points or right. A lot of activity coming out of it.
But again, we had the first jam that lasted less than 20 seconds.
It was nothing,
let's do it again.
And that's what we're kind of seeing here. It's like, you know, it seems like both teams are just trying to feel each other out a little bit, see who's going to end up finding the formations. I mean, we are getting quick lead sets.
Yes.
But it's not really working out into points.
All right, first stoppage of play coming. Let's see what it is. We're checking the scoreboard. Looks like it's going to be an official timeout. Yes, official timeout being indicated by the referees out there. Speaking of referees, let's go through the referees if we get a chance.
There you go. Well, we have Chunk Rock Girl, strong female character, Dilly Gaff, Marie Yvonne Slap, Evie Does It, Nacho, Recordian, Chemical Restraint, Elder Hormon, Queen of Catitude, Darth Bling, Fickle Bitch, Chemical Restraint, Apron, Morticia, Ricochet, and William Moore.
All right, give it up for the officials. And now out on the jammer line, number 223 in the gray team is Valkyrie Vixen. And number 316 on the white team is Riveter Rosie.
And we're going to go ahead and have a multiplayer call coming out there. Just Abby going off to the penalty box for a sit. So we're going to have even blockers. Well, I say even. Now we're going to go once again. Lucky Eddie's going to go have a sit down at the penalty box. And what a surprise. Two fewer blockers and lead is established.
Happy Valley leading on leads 5-3. Track cut coming in. Who's leaving? That is a Happy Valley skater leaving on a track cut. Number 84, Wham Bam Julianne.
Yeah, like I said, we're having fewer players out here in play, but it's not really relating into points. And yep, one comes on, one leaves. This is what we're doing.
Yeah, that's an illegal contact on kicking assets. Takes her off the track.
Yeah, both teams look like they're still not quite settled in here in the early morning of this game thus far.
Two for gray for a total of six. That is the first time either team has made multiple scoring passes, and we have another lead change. 15 playing 14, 10 minutes in.
Well, and this is what we said. I mean, yeah, it is a big differential in how they're seeded coming in this. But there's, like I said, I'm going to say it again. There is a lot of parity in this tournament.
All right, Suki Slap Pounce on the line up against Talia. Multiple jams for both of them, but the first time they're facing each other. They've both been on the jam line three times, but this is their first head-to-head appearance.
Yeah, once again, we lose a V-Town blocker out of penalty box for a multiplayer. Slap House keeping at it.
Back-to-back leads for Happy Valley. First time since jams one and two that they've picked up back-to-back leads.
Yeah, looking at it right now, Suki Slaphouse has the potential to be the leading scorer in the early goings. With that pass, it does at nine, which actually is a lot of points so far considering we've just got 19 and 14.
Blocking and with the head is the call on the V-Town jammer.
Yeah, usually that comes when you see a jammer getting in there, trying to lean in to create some power and just put that head into the body of the blocker and then spin out there. 4 points onto the board, going for Slap House.
Now that's the highest jam of the game, and not done yet.
Well, and I was pretty much thinking that, you know, so goes Happy Valley. It'll be on the wheels of Slap House. Slap House having been here before in some postseason tournament play.
Wow, getting around that brace two wall like nobody's business.
Yeah, just that little high step, little walk over there, not having to take a, you know, people love to see the apex jumps, but it takes a lot out of the body. A lot nicer to see it just coming over with a two-step.
You don't have to get aerial as long as your feet move fast.
Decent little ride out there at the end by the captain. Busty Chops able to buy a little bit more time.
Okay, both teams back at full strength now. Oh no, and a track cut. This is going to be our first 2 minute jam of the game as lead is lost.
And I was curious about that because Suki Slap House has been prone at times to grab penalties. I mean, dynamic skater, gets lead, gets points, but sometimes goes for that little extra when maybe not needed.
Look at that. More than doubling the score from 15 to 31 on the back of a 16 point jam. And now there's some separation on the board.
So already starting off long ways away. I'm interested to see how they're going to try this formation on offense here. It looks like Happy Valley's going to try and play that little bit of that. Well, no. I thought they were going to play a little bit of that runaway D with the way they were set up at the front. Now they're going to go ahead and accept any kind of damage that V-Town wants to throw at him.
So Suki starting from the penalty box on that track cut, and that is little Red Kaboom. First appearance on the jammer line, picking up lead.
Okay, for a minute there, I thought we were going to have a late track cut assessment on our jammer, but no, it's going to go against the pivot. So even when Slap House gets out there, not going to have that pivot, should get bottled up here, and they're already ready in this initial apex.
And Happy Valley just lost another blocker, so only two blockers out on the track right there for Happy Valley.
Oh, another nice step through on the inside. That time, their natural defense led to offense, bottling everybody out to the outside of turn two.
Basically untouched around the outside. That's always a nice feeling. Pick up 4 points that way.
Yeah, and this is where that issue of having your pivot in the penalty box came into play. Happy Valley having to wait it out. Bought another pass around.
So matching 16-point jams. Well, that's a 15, I think. Don't lose those 12 points just yet. There's more coming, no. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, no, I mean, but like I said, you should see these back and forths. I mean, and so far, it's like, you know, we got our producer over here. I was asking, you know, Cakes is like, have you seen a blocker that really has drawn your eye? And it's same thing for me. There is so much churn going on out here in these defenses. It's just nobody's really able to line up and right. You can see where that
everybody's standing out, so nobody's standing
exactly.
out.
Exactly. It is a full team effort.
Busy Hummingbird on the lineup against Berkey Knights.
Yeah, and see right now, Happy Valley trying to play that early offense actually went against them, actually opened up the hole for Happy Valley. Yeah, got in the mix, stepped out, go ahead and calls it off.
Pick up that single point. Makes it a 35 to 26 game. Heading into jam number 12.
See, it's going to have to be, you know, right now it's kind of spread around on the offensive abilities for V-Town. You know, they're kind of getting there. Boogie Knights has had a bit of an issue. Can't get lead. You know, Riveter Rosie can't get lead. So we're coming in here. Kaler, you know, 2 of 3, but only 8 points out of those. So just single pass runs.
And that's hip knocket therapy jamming for Happy Valley. But Kaler picks up lead.
Yeah, and therapy now just 1 of 3, no points onto the board. Good chip out there. Thought was going to have a bit of run. Wildchild seeing that and just took away that trajectory.
Pivots now bridging so that the rest of the blockers can put together walls. And everybody's back between those pivot line and jammer line.
So yeah, that time it looked like Kaler Swift saw something out there. Knew could get some blockers to end up kind of chasing the run a little bit. Got them split apart and found that gap in the middle. Yep, you're continuing to see it. Kaler Swift trying to play that lateral side to side, looking for any of those open spaces as Happy Valley trying to run to that offense, being down one blocker in that formation.
Yeah, B-Town loses. Zelda hits Gerald on a direction of play right before that jam comes to an end. 6 more points on the board, and holy cow, we've got us a game.
Yeah, already Happy Valley with 10 penalties onto the board. V-Town with 8. You know, and we're barely halfway through the first year. So, you know, that's, you keep projecting that out. That's potential, you know, 20 and 16 to end the first, you know, can run you up by that, you know, almost 40 apiece at the end of game. That's not really something you want to live by going through the rest of this game.
Mooner on the line up against Riveter Rosie. Penalty box has 1 each in it, so it's 4 on 4.
Yeah, and once again, both these teams kind of sticking with trying to run that offense, seeing the single blocker back there, you know, for V-Town while there's just 2 up front. And it's a little bit of a, I don't know, I find that a little bit of a risky move right now. I know you're kind of creating the pack and the bridge there at the back, but just right there, all it takes is getting one of those blockers off edge just enough, and you get that pass through.
First star pass of the game goes to number 38 on the 36 on the white team, Busty Chan. Oh no, track had called. So that is as the jammer.
Yeah, obviously, I thought there was going to be a potential back block coming in here from Mooner, but I believe Mooner caught just enough of the side of the body of the blocker that it didn't happen. I think even their bench thought that may be coming as well.
Also, Mooner, you saw looking in towards the coach for a call-off, but then they picked up the power jam and said, no, we're not calling anything off. Let's milk this a little bit.
So, yeah, that time it looked like V-Town walked themselves into that, but they were able to break out and reform at the front. Happy Valley thought they were going to get a trap defense. Good job by the Dames to get out of that. Oh, there goes one of my blockers now that's already doing it. Rita Villan just really playing a single blocker there, holding it up for the rest of the team to get back into the mix. Yeah, Bobby, a lot of activity out here on this track. I mean, there's a lot of skating going on amongst these blockers. I mean, you know, you kind of, this is a blocker, you kind of don't want to be the one doing all the skating. You want to leave that up to the jammers because that can tire you out. I know it's early in the day, but whichever team wins this one, they can take on Rocky later on tonight. And so you kind of
right?
maybe want to have a little bit of legs left in you.
Happy Valley puts 8 points on the board, brings them up to 43. So 43 playing 32, roughly a 4-3 ratio if you use 11 as your common denominator. And speaking of 11, number 11 on the white team is Talia, and that's Valkyrie Vixen on the line for Happy Valley.
Interesting move. They put a Slap House in there as the pivot. Actually getting up there and running the offense as a four. I'm going to be losing, that is number 84, and did we say we're going to call it Gray?
Gray, sure.
Gray, Wham Bam Julianne going off. So we got the advantage out there right now, but Slap House taking the deep drawback. So this may be it. That they're trying to use a jammer to kind of track a jammer, perhaps.
And back-to-back leads once again for Happy Valley. It's the third time they've strung 2 leads in a row together.
Yeah, I'm still keyed in on that Happy Valley using Slap House as the pivot here. Potential to get those penalties while not jamming.
And So some quick stats just come in from Chloroform Cupcake. Knockin' is 50% Jammerline. Slap House is 100% on the Jammerline. Valkyrie 75%. Busy 100% on the Jammerline. And Mooner's 50% on the Jammerline. And over on the V-Town side, Talia's 50%. Bergie has yet to pick up lead, but Kayler Swift is 100% on the Jammerline. River Rosie also has yet to pick up lead, but Little Red is 100% on the Jammerline.
Yeah, and so you go back to that point I was trying to say about Slap House, you know, all that success, the leading score of all jammers here, and you use as a blocker.
Right.
You know, it's kind of,
shows versatility.
It does. And it's early, so maybe, you know, you can kind of get away with that in the early going. Yeah, V-Town looked like they were trying to get the track cut call there with the run back, but it didn't happen. I'll be interested to see what comes of this, if they maybe go to review that. As the star cap has been passed now, we now have a new jammer out there for the Dames.
Yeah, that's number 18, Kayler Swift.
And there they go. They're using their jammer as a pivot in this jam. I see what you did, and I'll return the favor.
Turnabout is fair play. That helmet cover not very securely on Kayler's helmet.
This looks like, there it is. Kayler trying to do the usual zigzag move, not able to do it, refill in the pack as Busy Hummingbird just looking to muscle through, and it is successful.
And the cover did come off. The cover's back there right at the jammer line.
Yeah, you saw that. You caught that immediately.
Still not on very well. Yeah, this trouble getting it over the rim of the helmet.
Yeah, I think it's the style of helmet. It's with that hockey visor. You see that with the difficulty a lot of times. Seems to be a pretty good defense to match up against Kayler Swift on this one.
Look at that. Busy's put 16 points on the board while we've been jammering. Or she's been jammering while we've been yammering. How about that?
No, that is true. That will happen quite often today.
So already has tied the highest individual jam of the game and has points on this pass. So this will be the highest jam.
Yeah, good wing coverage right now coming out of here from Orange Crusher for Happy Valley on the outside and on the inside. That was kicking assets. They're both just, neither one of them are taking that little leap to try and, you know, go with Kayler Swift on those little jump outs. So they're staying home, and that's the thing that Swift was using to get beats on the last time, to get the, you know, to beat the blockers and get the points on the last run.
So 2 minutes ends the jam. That was not called off. And 21 points represents a third of Happy Valley's score. Brings them up to 64. And it's a 3-2 ratio using 2-1 ratio using 32 as your common denominator.
Yeah, and I'm going to call that a big win right now for Happy Valley. Not just on the points, but the fact that Kayler Swift at that juncture was the leading scorer for V-Town. And now you just put her out there, you know, just put out as a pivot.
Right.
Worn out once getting the jammer. So now you don't quite get that natural jam rotation to have Kayler be back in there. So you're going to have to kind of reshuffle the deck just a little bit.
Our second stoppage of play is the first team timeout by V-Town. Clock frozen at 7 minutes and 40 seconds. Hey, do we have some sponsors we can thank while we have this stoppage of play?
Well, yes. We have Rydell. They have radar wheels. Have you ever tried radar wheels?
I have not. I am not a skater. I have to confess, no.
I have the good wheels. WFTDA Continental Cups are brought to you by Radar Wheels, Radar Halo, experience world-class edging. And see, that's the one thing I probably don't do very well. I'm decent at getting my edging. But yes, good wheels do help. Radar Wheels, part of the Radar family, one of our sponsors here at the North America West, 2019 North America West Continental Cup.
Here. All right, so we got Mooner on the line up against Little Red Kaboom. 64 for Happy Valley, 32 for V-Town. V-Town in the white, Happy Valley in the gray if you're just tuning in.
Yeah, and Little Red Kaboom had that big jam, kind of got V-Town back into it. Once again, we're seeing it now settle out. This Happy Valley defense kind of was a little bit chaotic there while V-Town was making that run. Makes sense. Now just absolutely locking in and not taking the back cuts as lead going to the Molly Morbids.
Yeah. Little Red, this is only the second appearance for Little Red on the jammer line. Took advantage of that power start back in jam number 10.
So yeah, now we're seeing it again here. Now it's V-Town trying to get their multi-point of contact set here on defense. And good backing up, trying to take back some of that track as Mooner trying to find some space on the edges.
I like how V-Town uses their pivot as the wrecking ball up at the top of the wall. Gives you the chance to pass the star if you want to. And I also just like to see people trying to break down those walls and instead of just letting the jammer handle it. Drexel play penalty coming in at the very end. V-Town is going to be losing a blocker. So they will start one down. That was number 7, Lucky Eddie, on the direction of play. 6 minutes and change left to play. 67 playing 32.
So yeah, both teams actually kind of settling in a little bit on some of those penalty calls they were getting when we were just seeing just routinely a player just sliding off to take a seat. So it's 12-10, Happy Valley. I would say the disadvantage. Sometimes you think the better number, the higher number is better, but not at this point. So they're kind of evened up in their penalties. So not a huge advantage coming there thus far.
Valkyrie Vixen up on the line and going against Birdie Knights, and Valkyrie Vixen picks up lead. So neither team has had 3 leads in a row, but Happy Valley's had 2 leads in a row 4 times this game.
Yeah, and this time now, it's a good divide and conquer move coming out here from Valkyrie Vixen. Good, quick, little sharp steps to be able to redirect the blockers and take advantage.
Busty Chomps is the pivot out there for V-Town. Busty Chomps has had the star pass to her before. It's a 4-point pass. Here comes the cover off.
So now V-Town trying to add into their penalty total. One blocker left the track advantage, blocking-wise, going for Happy Valley. Happy Valley not... Oh, I was waiting to see it. I was like, are they going to choose to use that extra blocker to run some offense? And finally broke in there, but really the jammer did the work with the back down and another blocker.
Yeah, that's Busty Chops, the pivot to the penalty box on a forearm. Kind of stalled out at this first apex. A little bit of a skip gets through. Another 4 points. That's a dozen.
Yeah, Happy Valley really has calmed down their feet now. You used to see a lot of sliding back and forth trying to cover the edges. Now they're waiting for that jammer to make the commitment to where they want to go and just kind of capturing them there.
Look at that, a 20-point pass. That is one shy of the highest individual tally of the game. Low block coming in.
Yeah, a bit of a star cap protection move there coming from V-Town. Triple X was looking to try and cover that cap. Just a quick sweep out.
There was no low block assessed. I mistook one of the referee hand signals. There was no whistle that accompanied it. So both teams are at full strength.
So yeah, out of the penalty box now with the cap in hand. You can see it a little bit right now in the face of Busty Chops.
Yeah, the star was passed to Busty right there at the very end. 28
points. There was some frustration in that jam out of E-Town. You could see it on the face of the blockers and really saw it at the end there when Chops got knocked out hard.
On the basis of that one jam alone, Happy Valley almost put up as many points as V-Town scored the whole game. V-Town has not put any points on the board since jam number 12, when they put 6 points on the board by this very jammer that's on the line right now, number 18, Kaylor Swift.
Well, and as I said, it's really come in as the way that the two teams have settled in defensively. That really has been the change of pace. They were both playing a fairly similar kind of loose pack structure there in the first, probably, say, 10 jams. But now you're watching Happy Valley really lock in.
We had 5 lead changes in the first 8 jams.
Yeah, I mean, you're just really seeing, you know, the Molly Morbids just lock in. They're kind of calm. You're seeing them protecting their edges. Nobody's trying to take a quick step to cover where they don't need to cover.
Strung out from turn 1 to turn 2, now trying to coalesce in turn number 2. First time either team has 3 lead jams in a row. That's Happy Valley stringing 3 together, and they've had 5 of the last 6.
Yeah, Omega have really shown out here in the last few jams, playing the offense there, sweeping in.
New white jammer. Can't get the uniform number just yet. 805.
Yeah, once again, continuing to see a very calm defense now from the Molly Morbids. Happy Valley just, and maybe that was, it was just a little bit of jitters kind of playing to the way the other team wanted to play when the game first started. And now, you know, you kind of get that talk over at the bench and go, hey, y'all.
Okay, this is what we could do.
Yeah, this is our game. Let's play our game now. And since Happy Valley started playing what obviously looks like their game, it's really turned the tide here.
Gray jammer wearing number 8, that's Suki Slaphouse. White jammer wearing number 316, that's Riveter Rosie. Here we go.
Already trying to look for a quick run-up offensive help from the pivot there at the start. Suki, though, just absolutely just kind of shaking and banging and does make that effort work out with the lead.
And now that's 4 leads in a row.
Happy Valley gets a lead jam designation. Yeah, once again, you're just seeing this V-Town defense. They're really just dividing apart right now. And, I mean, some of it is, you know, trying to reform through some of this offense, which they actually did a very good job of that in the early goings.
You know, nice block there by Jim Nasty at the very end, forcing that call off, force the jammer out, and rather than re-engage, sees the V-Town jammer come in and decides to call off the jam. 2 points were picked up, which brings Happy Valley to 10 squared. And V-Town sitting on 32 since jam number 12.
Yeah, and this is the other side of it. Neither team seems to favor a front or back set. You know, they're kind of going where they want to go. And maybe some of the coaching from the bench tries something different.
Yeah, you got to adapt out there. Especially if you're V-Town, you got to start making some adaptations pretty darn quick. Nice block by V-Town.
Yeah, and this time it was a multiplayer coordinated effort. A lot of times we've been seeing those as a single player.
Right, right. Yeah. Like we saw last jam with Jim Nasty just single-handedly taking the jammer outside.
So then this may be the moment that, you know, every team just has those points in games where you kind of, it's like, you know, 404 Derby not found. And now that it seems
hit
like
the V-Town reset button and try again.
Hey, that's what you got to do. And right now it looks like V-Town saying, well, Happy Valley, you like that multi-point defense. We're going to do the same.
Pack now in retrograde.
Holy smokes, Bobby. I just looked in and saw what the clock time was. And
holy cow, it's halftime.
Isn't it, though?
How about that? 103 playing 32. And, both teams do have an official review, although I don't see any coaches putting their heads together or anything like that, so I doubt we're going to get an official review. So 103 playing 32 heading into the second half of the first day, game two of the 2019 Women's Flat Track Derby Association Continental Cup North America West here in Orem, Utah. I'm Bobby Narco.
I'm Spear the House.
Our producer is Chloroform Cupcake. Come on back in about 10 minutes or so. We'll have some statistical analysis and the second half of Happy Valley versus V-Town. Hey now, and welcome back to the 2019 Women's Flat Track Derby Association Continental Cup North America West, coming at you from the Utah Community Credit Union Center here in Orem, Utah. Yep. I'm Bobby Narco. I'm joined by the Speaker of the House. Speaker, what do you got from the feed, from the Twitch feed?
Well, so we do know some people are actually watching us.
Okay.
They're watching this game. We got from the Apex, you know, said, we need to get you on skates, Bobby. Apex wants you on skates, and Johnny Pepper down there in the great heart of Texas is, you know, he has a Texas size all-inclusive howdy from the heart of Texas, and that man has a big heart.
Oh, he does indeed. So. Peace, love, and Pepper going out to good buddy Johnny Pepper. And then in terms of statistical analysis, I have some really briefly that I can go over with you. In terms of lead jam, Happy Valley had lead jam 15 times. V-Town only had the lead 5 times. Happy Valley jammers made 1 trip to the penalty box. V-Town jammers made 2 trips to the penalty box. Star passes really are the major difference in the game and lead jams, but star passes, V-Town passed the star 4 times, and Happy Valley has yet to past the star. There were 2 scoreless jams. There were 2 jams that went 2 minutes long. Highest individual jam was 28 points put up on the board in jam number 17 by number 223, Valkyrie Vixen.
Yeah, and we were noticing early on that, you know, at the early part, it was Happy Valley that was kind of getting a little more traction in the penalty box than they would have liked. And V-Town kind of came back and, you know, started going to the penalty box as well, which is also indicative of the leads, the points, the differential we have now. You know, Happy Valley really settled in. And so, you know, it's basically 12 apiece, so that's fairly even. But, I mean, if you kind of look at it, it's a little mixed, and it's kind of a lot of, for both teams, it's forearms, track cuts. And, you know, coming from Happy Valley, multiplayer. And I think a lot of those started showing up more when they were getting back and getting reconnected. And then you're seeing the directions as the, you know, the alternate from the track cut and the forearm coming for V-Town. And a lot of times you see those directions, it's when you're trying to get your jammer free because you are not getting lead and that offense goes in the wrong direction.
Or someone's been forced out and so the pack goes in retrograde and next thing you know you're backing into somebody who's already got position. So second half is underway. Hypnocket Therapy on the line up against Talia.
Yeah, once again, starting off a little bit solid. A little more left to right coming again from Happy Valley.
All white at the top of the pack, all gray at the back of the pack. Both teams committing 1 blocker to bridging. Jammer forced at the top of the pack, forced to the outside. And now the jammer at the top of the pack is the jammer at the back of the pack. Not for long.
Yeah, these V-Town jammers really look like they want to incorporate that left to right action to try and find those gaps in the middle.
Lead jam goes to Happy Valley.
Yeah, it's just settled in again, though, Happy Valley. They were kind of doing a little bit of the left to right, but they were maintaining continuity in the center, so no cutback lane in there for Taya. So that's going to really help keep this lead streak alive for Happy Valley.
Yeah. Mia Love You Long Tie was up there trying to play the wrecking ball, but had to drop back to bridge to keep the white jam or the white blockers in play at the back of the pack.
So, yeah, you know, you see them divided out, and, you know, V-Town, you know, they're kind of locked in and playing, so they're not having to play that recycle move anymore, so they're not breaking themselves up. But now the distance is.
Got to coalesce. First penalty of the second half coming in. It's a direction of play. Eagle Eye, Chloroform, Cupcake spotting penalties for us. And V-Town losing a blocker to the penalty box on the direction of play.
Yeah, we just saw it again. When the two packs get intermixed, Happy Valley's coming out the beneficiary of it, forcing V-Town to have to kind of divide to recycle, and it's opening up the spaces.
V-Town completes the initial. Happy Valley picks up four, goes for another scoring pass, and picks up two on the second scoring pass. Total of six brings Happy Valley up to 109. V-Town not scoring keeps them at 32. Suki out on the line for Happy Valley, wearing that gunmetal colored jersey. And number 240, that's Bergie Knights heading out there for V-Town.
Yeah, right now I would not be surprised. Yep, I thought that was going to try and see if you're going to get a follow through on the offensive track from Slap House.
Slight pack advantage for Happy Valley with Mia Love You Long Tie in the penalty box from the last jam. Lead jam goes once again to Happy Valley. And now number eight is 5 for 6 in terms of getting lead jam. Was 4 for 5 in the first half, now 5 for 6. And 4 points on the board for Suki Slap House.
Yeah, getting an opportunity now for the multi-pass run. Something we didn't actually see Slap House get. Oh, a little shake and bake. Are we going to get it? Yes, we do.
Back block.
Yep.
Lead is lost. Second 2-minute jam of the game. First of the half.
Yeah, I think that position, maintaining that rear part of that, it was kind of an inverted V there. I think that one actually came help from the side blockers, keeping that center blocker from going too far, or else it would have gotten in the side.
Still the initial pass for V-Town. Multiplayer block should loosen things up a little bit as Happy Valley loses Wham Bam Julianne to the penalty box.
Yeah, and here it is. Once again, you're trying to see the Dames trying to cap off the top. And speaking of caps, we've got the cap passed now. We're going to have Zelda Fitzgerald as the jammer.
The fifth star pass of the game for V-Town. First of the half. And the second time it's gone to number 805, Zelda. So Happy Valley's jammer back in and scoring. Did get a whistle there, and it's on the jammer. Cupcake, did you see the call? It's a track cut.
So yeah, we're going to end up running this one down to the end of the clock, so you're not going to have to do the freeze out here at the end. It's going to just naturally happen.
That's going to be a power start and a forearm penalty at the very end on Mia Love You Long Tie. So Mia is going to start the second jam in a row from the penalty box, and a power start for Happy Valley with the pivot wearing the star, Zelda Fitzgerald, is going to be the jammer of record heading into jam number 3.
I don't know. Don't forget, you're going to stick around. I know you are. The next game will be Sacramento versus Red Stick, and the winner of this game plays Rocky later on tonight at 8, and the team that doesn't win, I don't want to say losers, because everybody's coming here as the winner.
Comes in second?
Yeah, they will play again tomorrow at 4 p.m.
All right, taking the power start, that's Valkyrie Vixen. Zelda Fitzgerald starting in the penalty box on the track cut from the last jam. Not picking up lead. Last jam, V-Town did get their first points since jam number 12 of the first period, so brought them up from 32 to 35. They've got their work cut out for them, but there's still lots of derby left to play. Another star pass. New jammer for V-Town. Number 18, Kaylor Swift. No surprise there.
So yeah, trying to use Kaylor as the pivot now on a few occasions. Looking to maybe see, like there, if you can get the late jump out, grab some points without a lot of the heat from the blockers. But you know what? Happy Valley defense is, they're locking it down. That's 13 times. No points on the board for V-Town.
Yeah. So, Kaylor was the most effective jammer for V-Town in the first period. Kaylor went 3-for-4 on the jammer line, picking up lead, and picked up 14 of the of V-Town's points. And now here we go. Busy Hummingbird up against Little Red Kaboom. Kind of a couple of relief-ish jammers, although Busy got a fair number of starts.
Yeah, and trying a little bit of a quick run back. So both teams, forearm now, going to just leave us with three out there. Had a blocker in the pack there, trying to play the bridge. So it's effectively just two blockers.
He goes to Happy Valley. V-Town has not picked up lead since gem number 12 of the first period when they got those 6 points.
Yeah, I'm telling you, once Happy Valley decided to play that reconnected defense again, this has just been an entirely just strong defensive effort. You know, we talk about the jammers, but it's this defense has really made this happen for Happy Valley.
Good hip check by Lucky Eddie there at the back of the pack. Forces the jammer down, but the jammer is able to get back up and continue skating. 4 more points, an 8-point pass. It's now more than a 105-point lead. Both of these scores are divisible by 35. It is a 4-to-1 ratio.
So if you want more information on the WFTDA Continental Cups or their hosts, visit WFTDA.com/cups. And of course, it's never too early to start thinking about champs. Get those championship tickets. Make sure you have your passport.
Yeah, head on up to Montreal. First time the Women's Flat Track Derby Association Championships are going to be taking place outside of the United States of America.
And that'll be occurring November 15th through the 17th. Don't miss your chance to really go to a full international championships. If you live in the States, of course, if you come from other countries, it's always someplace else, you know.
We got Talia on the line for V-Town going up against Suki Slaphouse for Happy Valley. Penalty box is empty. We've got 80 wheels out there between the jammer line and pivot line. And just like that, lead is picked up by Suki Slaphouse. Suki 2-for-2 this half and was 4-for-5 in the first half, so 6-for-7 as lead jam this game.
See, another time kicking assets, getting out there, patrolling the edge, got knocked out, came back in, but it's now sitting back up into the middle of that. Kicking assets, really a very active blocker out here for Happy Valley.
Nice blocking at the top of the pack by number 131 on the gray team. That's kicking assets, yeah.
Yeah, it's, once again, really doing a very coordinated and just sealing these edges. You can tell these V-Town jammers want to find that absolute bit of a seam, and if they can take it to the outside or inside, they will, but they're just not giving it up anymore as Happy Valley.
Yeah, apex jump was attempted, but couldn't get over O-negative, so apex jump was foiled, but not that time. There's an apex jump, calls off the jam, picks up 4 points. As the V-Town jammer escapes the pack. A dozen more points on the board brings Happy Valley up to 154.
And I want to give a shout out to Rydell at Rydell.com. Powerdyne is part of the Rydell family. If a maneuverable and reactive plate is what you were looking for, then look no further than the Arius Platinum from Powerdyne. Arius Platinum, performance redefined.
Mooner out there on the jammer line for Happy Valley. Mooner had 3 appearances on the jammer line in the first period, was 2-for-3. First appearance this half, and that's number 240, Bergie Knights, out there on the jammer line for V-Town. Bergie Knights still looking for her first lead, but Mooner picks up lead for Happy Valley.
Yeah, I think one of the things we're continuing to see is the fact that lead is getting so quick for Happy Valley most of the time.
That's 14 lead jams in a row for Happy Valley, yeah, going back to the second period.
I think we're seeing V-Town get caught between offensive defense quite a bit here now, so they're a little bit more loosely formed and distracted while they're trying to get their jammer through and the opposing jammer coming in.
Three more points added to the Happy Valley tally brings them up to 157. V-Town still sitting on 35.
So, yeah, we're going to have Keller Swift back out here as a natural jammer this time, not just kind of swinging it from the pivot position.
And first appearance on the jammer line this half for Keller Swift. Keller Swift had made four appearances on the jammer line in the first half. Number 503, the gray counterpart, Hypnocket Therapy, was 2-for-4 in the first half, was 1-for-1 in the second half.
Yeah, once again, you're just trying to see these Derby Dames trying to find these edges, and they're just being sealed up right now. Even taking the long back cut, not successful.
Not lead, first out, but not lead. Cannot catch a break for V-Town.
Oh, and the star cap came off, so.
2 minute jam.
Oh, nice step over the inside. Not only was it just a step over, but actually got the body set ready to go ahead and flip the hips and come through it backwards and keep the foot from tracing to the inside, so no track cut. And did it again on the outside. Just good angle edging there. We talked about edging.
This is the first jam in the game where neither team has had lead. Up until this point, one team or the other had been able to get leads. Occasionally it on a jammer penalty. There we
well,
go.
Who knows? This open for, you know, this kind of open set play now might be benefiting V-Town, kind of, because you can see Happy Valley getting a little more loose in their packs.
Dozen points on the board for V-Town represents a quarter of their score, and not done yet.
So it's going to get ourselves a few turns of the track. Now you're seeing Happy Valley settle back in, doing what they were doing prior to both jammers getting out and scoring opportunities, but just a little bunny hop. That's all it is. It's just that slight little hop is all that needs.
Still 20 seconds left. Those 16 points represent 32% of V-Town's score.
Happy Valley doing a much better job of being able to convert their defense to offense and then turning it back around.
Kayla tries to get low, but gets low bridged by that wall.
And that time tried to play a little bit of that defense, maybe making this an even jam. And look at that, a little bit of a step through. Thought possibly the foot came back to the inside there before the fourth whistle.
So this is the highest combined jam of the game. 15 points for Happy Valley, bringing them up to 172. And 20 points on the board for V-Town. Their highest jam of the game brings them up to 55.
And Quantum Mechanic out there in the Derbyverse is super grateful to the announcers for bringing happy Derby sounds to my ears and making my workday brighter.
Well,
this is kind of our work. Well, I'd say it's our workday. Happy workday employees. We get paid.
But happy birthday. Thank you for joining us for some awesome roller derby action on your birthday. Valkyrie Vixen is on the line for Happy Valley, and Riveter Rosie on the line for V-Town. Rosie picks up lead jam for, excuse me, Valkyrie picks up lead jam for Happy Valley.
Well, and there once again, it is that quick lead advantage coming for Happy Valley. You just kind of have to turn it over. This time the offense came out successful for V-Town to get their jammer out quick, but it has not been the case for much of this game. You get the quick lead. That quick lead turns into
a battle for points.
Yeah, well, it turns into that potential offense coming from V-Town, and that Happy Valley defense has been really strong since midway through the first half. And that attempted offense usually leads to a blind look at the jammer, and that's quick points for Happy Valley. But this time, that offense came in fast.
Busy Hummingbird out on the line for Happy Valley. Perfect on the jammer line so far. 4-for-4 in the first half, 1-for-1 in this half. And that's Talia on the line for V-Town.
Well, now that you're starting to see the scoring leads even up here for Happy Valley, Hummingbird coming in with 39.
High block call sends a blocker to the penalty box. 84, Wham Bam Julian.
Well, that was a physics lesson there.
Nothing. Our third scoreless of the game. of the half.
You have two bodies that come into contact at with force and momentum. That force and momentum is going to be repelled, and it repelled both skaters to the deck on one and led to that 0-0 there. But yeah, Hummingbird coming up with 39. Slaphouse with 53, Vixen with 46, so they're kind of even across the board.
And Newton's laws of thermodynamics being put on full display here. Skating out of bounds is the call on the pivot. Lead jam goes to Happy Valley. Happy Valley's jammer is Suki Slaphouse, and that's Bergie Knights. Now just clearing the pack on the initial for V-Town.
Yeah, doing a better job in the last few jams is V-Town, getting their jammer freed a lot quicker, so we're not seeing those multi-pass attempts coming from Happy Valley.
Four more points. Happy Valley hits it, quits it, brings them up to 180, and V-Town still sitting on 55 for the last three jams.
Yeah, Mooner coming out here has been successful getting lead, but it hasn't really translated into the points. Still on a positive side of the differential coming in here by plus 11, but 14 points, it's, you know, being the kind of the lowest score thus far for Happy Valley.
Right. It's, you're in the positive, but your teammates have so much more positive than you do.
Oh, barrel roll there. Hey!
Hey, first lead for V-Town since jam number 12 of the first period.
Yeah, the stranglehold on lead has been just incredible by Happy Valley. I'd probably choose better words. That's not a good word choice, but I mean, they've owned it.
Domination?
Domination, yes, sir. They have owned it. They have just owned this 100%.
Directional play penalty sends one of the V-Town blockers to the penalty box. That is number 36, Busty Chops on the directional play.
Yeah, and this has been it right here. You see V-Town. When they settle in, they are just absolutely keeping the bodies, you know, on point, not surrendering those edges where you're trying to see these V-Town jammers, if they can make the quick slip through and not have to go through like three bodies up the middle.
Cupcake, do we have a star pass? Oh, no.
Just had the attempted there, and once again, we're losing blockers off the penalty box. We're racking them up here now. You know, Happy Valley has stayed pretty calm here in the second half, not losing too many players off the penalty box. V-Town starting to rack it up a little bit more. You tend to see that from a team, you know, if they're trying to do a little bit more than they normally do.
Somebody's going to be heading to the penalty box with a low block and then another penalty for not leaving fast enough. What was that note? Would you get a chance to take a look at that?
Yeah, they were just looking to see about finally getting a star pass out of the Happy Valley jammer rotation, which, quite frankly, they really haven't needed to do. I mean, with the if you're owning lead, you don't need to pass the star.
So 180 playing 61, roughly a 3-1 ratio. Number 11 on the white team is Talia, and number 223 on the gray team is Valkyrie Vixen.
Yeah, back block, going to be losing one of the Happy Valley blockers off. That's O-negative, usually in there as an offensive help. Likely took that as an offensive help move there. Was out there in the lonesome up front with the packs.
Valkyrie Vixen picking up lead. And that gray wall at the top of the pack, just invincible.
Well, you can see they calmed themselves down early in the first and have just been staying very well connected and playing to the game plan they won. They like playing that 3-1, getting the offense.
Low block called. Happy Valley losing a blocker on the low block.
Yeah, just trying to stretch out that engagement just a little bit long with the leg. And, a little bit of a zigzag there. Maybe potential.
What?
A fourth whistle call coming in for contact, but didn't happen.
Two sneaky points picked up by V-Town. Brings them up to 63.
Yeah, that's always a tough call there, Bobby. You know, you're in there, you hear the fourth whistle come, and you don't want to be pointed, but you also don't want to get that blocking after the whistle call.
Tough split-second decision has to be made in situations like that. Number 240 on the white team, Bergie Knights. And number 8 on the gray team, Suki Slaphouse. Here we go. Jam number 13 of the second period, jam number 33 of the game is underway.
And yeah, it's going to actually be another lead coming for V-Town here in the last few jams. That 3-3 start looked like it helped out.
And there's a penalty on the jammer. It's a track cut.
So after remaining really calm out there on the track, you're now starting to see Happy Valley add up some penalties here onto the board in the last three jams, where you have seen the success coming for V-Town.
Still only three jammer penalties on the game for Happy Valley. It really, both teams actually have done a very good job of keeping their jammer out of the box. Both teams with three jammer penalties.
So just trading off contact here. You saw it, you know, just trying to work off each other. Wham Bam Julianne trying to roll there and keep coordinated effort with kicking assets.
V-Town has put points on the board in the last three jams. That's the first time in the game where they've scored in three consecutive jams.
So a lot of love for some of the names out here from the players. Come from Ermagerd, says Killer Swift is a very good derby name, and so is Wham Bam Julianne. I do kind of like that one.
Yes. Number 18 is Kaylor Swift, speaking of good derby names. And on the line for Happy Valley is Hypnocket Therapy. Kaylor picks up lead. That's two in a row for V-Town. Look at this. Here come the Dames. Directional play penalty sends the Dames penalty box. A pivot to the penalty box. That Zelda hits Gerald.
Yeah, and this might be something they want to try and do is V-Town, try to see if they can figure out to maybe play, I'm going to say, play a little bit of a speed game here, open up some space, because that's what right now a jammer like Kaylor Swift is looking for, that space, because every time Kaylor goes into the middle of that pack, it's just shoulder to shoulder and the wind goes to Happy Valley.
Happy Valley being held scoreless two jams in a row for the first time this game. Wow, so way off screen. Now you can see on the screen, number 316 starting for the white team is Riveter Rosie. Going to start all the way back from that second apex. And number 831 is Busy Hummingbird.
Yeah, tried to come in sweep for the block there. Took a little contact, inadvertent though. Probably did look shoulder. Busy Hummingbird has been absolutely fun to watch. It's like you're seeing it right there, that kind of sprightly step, the little bounce in the step.
Up lead is Busy Hummingbird, flitting around the hummingbird feeder.
Yeah, and those quick steps kind of really doesn't give the opposing defense an idea of where that last forward trajectory step is going to come from.
Illegal contact for the out of play block sends the Happy Valley pivot to the penalty box. That is number 0-0 negative for the illegal contact out of play block.
Yeah, negative has been out there running a lot of offense for this Happy Valley, you know, Happy Valley team, especially right here off the jam start. It's really been a huge asset in getting these lead advantages. You know, not enough can really be said about the fact that both of these teams have tried the offense, but it's Happy Valley that has really shown the success at it.
Right. Excellent observation there, Speaker of the House. On the line right now, we have Valkyrie Vixen going up against Talia.
Yeah, and I said that, and it was Zelda Hitz-Gerald trying for V-Town right off the beginning to get that offense. And once again, Happy Valley just absorbed it and rolled past it. Yeah, and there it is. You're looking at it right now. You know, they're trying to get into the seams of this Happy Valley defense. It just doesn't work. They're just standing up and just putting shoulders in there.
Once Happy Valley's pivot rejoins play, that's going to be all 10 skaters packed into the narrowest part of the track. Lead jam goes to V-Town. That is three of the last four and four of the last six.
Yeah, that time Talia did a good job of reading how strong the defense was in front. Oh, and there was a good seal offense there. Like I said, V-Town, they're kind of coming back again. They seem to be kind of reconnecting and rethinking about what they're doing as a game plan and locking in together. But that time, beautiful. Talia saw the defense was locked in up front, used them as a natural screen to take that outside.
Yeah, Valkyrie Vixen, might not have seen on the screen, was kind of campaigning the jam rep, saying, hey, you got to watch those elbows. I'm getting hit with elbows all over the place. We're out on the line now for Happy Valley, and number 821 is Little Red Kaboom. 5 minutes and 58 seconds remaining to play. We only have two stoppages of play in the first half. We haven't had any here in the second half. Lead gets picked up by Mooner. Oh, when a low block called on Little Red Kaboom. No, a low block called on a V-Town blocker.
Yeah, and I'm kind of happy here. It's like I said, you know, I always like it when I can sound prescient. I talked about Omegative running the offense at these jam starts. Omegative sealed up the outside, got that lead. Of course, good job by V-Town to get back in there and recapture and draw this back into the initial straightaway.
So Happy Valley opens up that outside line, but then V-Town closes it off at the top of the pack. Jammer forced the infield. Here we go again. Both jammers now at the back of the pack. And that's the initial for V-Town.
You know, I was kind of hoping that Happy Valley would have let a little more clock ride before that call off, because, you know, you're on the inside. You're not back in play yet. Nobody can touch you.
Nothing. Our third scoreless of the game, our fourth scoreless of the game, second of the half, keeps the score at 188-79.
So, yeah, V-Town now starting to find a number of players sitting on multiple penalties. Granted, we're getting late in this game, so probably won't be a factor in anybody fouling out. But you now have, you know, two players sitting on four players sitting on three. So, I mean, you know, that's bodies that aren't on the track to create the stoppage. You know, it's kind of adding up a little bit here in the second half again, but it hasn't hurt them quite as bad as it did in the first half.
Let's see there. It's 85-47. Happy Valley also winning the second half, but not winning the second half by as much as they won the first half. First stoppage of play in the second half comes with 5:08 left. It is the second team timeout by V-Town. This game has flown by. I'd like to thank all of the sponsors here. I'd also like to thank the Women's Flat Track Derby Association for the great work that they do with these tournaments.
Yeah, and we'd like to shout out to Rydell, Radar Wheels, Powerdown, Rollercon, you know, all these people. They helped to make all this possible. They underwrite a lot of this. And we want to thank the crews that are helping to bring this to us, you know, via the streams, you know, on the cameras, in the booths, switching these things and, you know, providing the audio for all this. This wouldn't be, you know, you wouldn't be hearing us at home if it weren't for them. So big shout out and thanks to those folks.
First jam of the game for Enterprise, number 2063 for the Happy Valley Derby Darlins, Molly Morbids.
So I'm wondering now if you're going to see Happy Valley kind of adjust fire a little bit here. I mean, still you got to worry about, you know, differentials and those going in, because they still factor, even though you do want to win the tournament.
Illegal position call, nobody leaving.
But the question is, are now we seeing an adjustment for Happy Valley's game, maybe trying to leave some in the tank for Rocky tonight?
That was the Happy Valley pivot leaving, and I did not catch the uniform number before she sat down in the penalty box.
Yeah, that's going to be number 521. That's Gypsy Wiper out. So, yeah, good, solid defense now, right, coming in from V-Town. Like I said, when they get that multi-point of contact, they're fine. When they don't take the jump step, they're fine. Same thing you've seen out of Happy Valley. But Happy Valley has done it more often.
Multiplayer now called on Triple X. That should thin things out at the top of the pack. Only really one blocker to beat up there. But a blocking clinic being put on at the top of the pack.
So, yeah, that's just a player-on-player action right here. Beautiful. Once again, it's one of those things that we've noticed. Both our producer, Cakes, and I have been noticing kicking assets, playing to the namesake.
And taking names. Star has been passed now. Only the second time that the first time that Happy Valley has passed the Star. Four-arm penalty coming in. Who's leaving?
Well, of course, this is actually coming from a pivot who just came out of the penalty box, tried to run the offense, gets through, though, does that little pick and pop to push forward.
And that's Gypsy getting the Star. Let's look at those tallies. Three more points on the board for B-Town, brings them up to 82. Hard-fought 3 points. Took a minute and change off the clock to pick them up. Happy Valley was held scoreless. They are sitting on 188 since the end of jam number 15. So held scoreless three jams in a row for the first time this game.
So apparently Twitter really likes Kayler Swift out there for V-Town. She's can't say I don't blame
shaking
him.
It up out there.
You know. So, and here we go. Kayler Swift back into action.
Taylor and Suki. Suki picks up lead for Happy Valley.
Yeah, have not seen too much of Suki Slaphouse here in the second half. Of course, you know, kind of played a little sparingly in the first as well. Jammed, played a lot of pivot there for a while as well.
Yeah, Suki had 5 jams in each period. This is Suki's 10th jam. And was 4-for-5 in the first period and is 4-for-5 in this period as well. So 80% on the jammer line getting lead.
Yeah, and actually in that, surprising, I'm sitting here looking at the numbers. I was looking at it, you know, saying, you know, Suki Slaphouse was the leading scorer of all scorers at one point in time, but now it's actually Busy Hummingbird. I was looking at the wrong numbers. Duh. If it helps if you look at the correct numbers. Nope. Slaphouse still is going to be the top scorer, but everybody else is creeping back in.
Yeah, Valkyrie Vixen also was the leading scorer at halftime.
Yeah, so now we're sitting at 50 for Vixen, 65 for Slap House, and 43 for Hummingbird as your top scores coming out of Happy Valley. And on the flip side, Taylor Swift, 41. So kind of matching up what the jammers for the opposing team are doing, but not quite able to, you know, oh, nope, sorry. They just took some points away for me on there. So it's 38 now for Taylor Swift. And the rest of the way, it's, you know, Bergie Knights, 2 for 10 on getting leads, 16 points, though. And Little Red Kaboom had that great jam to open up the game for us, you know, as the jammer. Hasn't really been able to get any traction on that afterwards. Only 1 for 4, 12 points. So, you know, it's been kind of a one-jammer game thus far for V-Town.
Yes, it's the Taylor Swift show.
Yeah, and you know, and it's and the means at which Taylor Swift has to get through right now, and same things that we're seeing here out of Talia, it's a lot of trying to find edge space.
So that was an official timeout. That was only our fourth stoppage of play this game. But that came with a 1:46 left in regulation. And now lead has been picked up by Hypnocket Therapy.
Yeah, once again, this Happy Valley defense just taking that little shake and bake move and a track cut. Going to give a power jam now opportunity for Happy Valley.
Multiplayer block also called on the pivot.
So they're going to be able to ride this clock out, especially since 30 seconds of that is going to be solo on the floor as the jammer comes back into the mix.
I would be surprised if Happy Valley were to call off this jam for any reason before that game clock hits zero.
Yeah, right now trying to play the two ball up here at the front. Did a good job. Been strong blockers all game long, or Rambo and Bad Juju, but it's been kind of a long game playing from behind.
Got a little bit of wrecking ball action being played by Gypsy Wipe around, trying to knock a hole in that white wall at the top of the pack.
Yeah, a little surprised we didn't have an OPAC call coming in there, and possibly Gypsy getting the pack destruction because ran up front and slipped back, but I guess we were just inside that 10 feet.
Penalty box back to empty. All of the skaters are on the track in between the pivot line and the jammer line. That's a four-point pass picked up by Hypnocket Therapy.
Yeah, and you can see it. The bench off to the outside is calling in. He's making aware of the time. Things going here. Really surprised coming back into it. Going to go ahead and continue to run this out.
Nice block by number 1308 on the white team, Rambo, forcing the jam to the outside, forcing the jammer to the outside, essentially forcing the call off. And that is the game. Unofficial final, 212-82. 16 points picked up there at the very end.
So, of course, with this victory, it's still not official. But, I mean, you know, I don't think there's going to be sufficient points to change the scoring of what we're having, you know, in this last jam.
Right. Both teams do have an official review, but I don't see anybody. In fact, Happy Valley already putting their cheer together, about to take their skate around lap.
But, yeah, this means Happy Valley will get here again this evening versus Rocky at 8 p.m. So I'm excited for that game because, I mean, you know, hopefully Rocky will travel here with some fans and we'll have some loud people in the audience and we'll get this going with the host team. So big ups to the host team getting the first victory in the books this morning.
Not too far away. Want to thank our alternate referee today. Our alternate referee was Richie Cranium, helping us out in terms of official timeouts. If there had been an official review, would have helped us out there as well. I'm Bobby Narco.
I'm Speaker of the House.
Our producer was Chloroform Cupcake. Stick around next. We have Sacramento versus Red Stick. Until then, we wish you peace, love, and roller derby.